Well, busy week continues for us. You know, I know the first two games obviously were a test, both in different ways, but nonetheless were a test, as we all saw. But this game tomorrow is going to be the biggest test we've had so far, without a doubt. So, you know, anytime you face a team that has 10 of their 12 players, I believe, are either juniors or seniors, you know you're going to be in for a war. So, you know, it's obviously the most experienced team we've played so far, and probably one of the most experienced teams we play all year, actually. But, you know, I know we beat them last year, but they're much improved from last year. They got a couple new guys that are really helping them. And, you know, like I said, it's going to be a good test. It's going to be a very, very good basketball game tomorrow night. I think our guys are anxious to get back out there and hopefully show some improvements in areas we needed to improve on since Friday. But, you know, like I said, Barry's done he's done a great job every year since he's been there. You know, they're always going to play physical, play hard, and that's no different this year when you got that many upperclassmen. So, you know, we're looking forward to it and just looking forward and anxious to get back out on the court.
How did your team respond after you're terming them the second half embarrassing? How did they respond to your criticisms there?
They saw it. We watched, you know, we didn't watch the whole game just for time's sake. We put together an edit of, you know, mostly actually all things we needed to work on and improve on in bad stretches of the game. And they saw it. I mean, they're mature enough that, you know, I asked them when we got done, I said, does anybody think I'm being too critical on you guys? And, you know, obviously none of them said yes, but, you know, they know. But with that being said, you know, in the first half, we did some good things. You know, we've played well in stretches the first two games this year. I just, you know, tomorrow I want to see us play well for a whole game. It seems like we haven't been able to put together 40 minutes yet. So that's the goal, is just try to put together a complete game. But, yeah, I mean, we have a mature group. Even our young guys are, you know, they saw it. They saw the film, and the old adage, the film never lies. So, you know, we had a very productive last couple of days. We had a very good practice yesterday. So I just got to have one more today and get ready to go. You know, it's kind of a combination of everything. And the ones that are really killing us are the, you know, what they call live ball turnovers, where, you know, I sometimes call them a pick six, where, you know, they'll get a steal and then they got a 1-0 break where there's nothing we can do to defend it. You know, at least sometimes when you turn the ball over, it's a dead ball turnover and you can set your defense. But it's the ones that have been live ball and then we struggle to get back and they have an advantage. So, you know, we just – now, look, you have to give George Mason and Omaha some credit. I mean, they forced – you know, a majority of our turnovers, but a lot of them also, we were just careless with the ball, just lackadaisical on our passes, just not being strong with the ball. So just things we've had to correct, but, you know, film is great in that regard because you can see where your mistakes are and where you need to fix them. So, you know, hopefully we'll make some strides in that area. You know, it's just a team effort. It's not really our guards need to do it or our bigs need to do it. It's a team effort. You know, all five guys on the defensive end need to go pursue the ball. And, you know, I know Dang had 8 the other night. You know, guys like VJ and Darius and Q, you know, they're the ones that, especially when you're playing against a team that shoots a lot of threes like Omaha did the other night, long shots is going to turn into long rebounds. So, you know, the guards have to come back and chase the ball down. You know, and our bigs have to – all of our guys actually just, they have to do just a better job of pursuing the ball. You know, there's, instead of letting the ball come to you, you got to rebound out of your area and go get the ball. And you know, we're big enough, we're athletic enough to where we should be doing that. And we've worked on it the last couple of days. You know, we've harped on that pretty good because that's definitely a weakness of our team right now is defensive rebounding. But, you know, it's just got to be a total team effort. It's got to be a mindset to say, when that ball goes up, we're finding it, we're locating it, we're going to get it. You know, he practiced really hard. You know, all of our guys practice hard. You know, don't get me wrong. It's not like some guys are dogging it. It's just all of our guys practice hard, but Malik just really, really practiced hard. The day before the Omaha game, Honest was a little bit under the weather in practice, so I just said, look, let's put Malik in there and see what happens. And, you know, he played well. And he actually is a guy that has a pretty good mindset of going to pursue the ball on the backboard. You know, he just is a freshman, so he's a little bit weaker. So if he gets bumped or knocked, it's going to knock him off balance. But, you know, all of our guys – they bring it every day in practice. you're not always going to have a great practice every day from an individual standpoint, just because it's a long year, but their effort's there every day. You know, it's just, it's a matter now of, and it has been for the last couple of weeks, of just teaching, you know, teaching the little things. Since we've had four chances now to play against other teams, just correcting what we see on film that we need to get better at. Yeah, we have to have one a week. You know, this starting last Friday to this coming Friday obviously is a tough stretch because we have three games in 7 days. So you got to be a little cognizant of not overdoing it. But, you know, like today, for example, we had practice yesterday. We did some stuff on Saturday. And our last off day, I believe, was last Tuesday. And so this morning, for example, we gave them individual instruction off. We didn't do individuals this morning just to kind of give them one less thing to do to try to, you know, save their legs a little bit so we can be fresh for practice. Obviously, we'll have a game tomorrow. And then Wednesday, Thursday, you got 2 day prep to get ready for Friday. So, you know, you just kind of got to tinker with it. But our guys seem to be for this time of year, seem to be in pretty good physical shape. But it's just, you know, it's a matter of not overdoing it because, you know, you got to make sure you cover your scouting report, you cover what you need to cover to get ready for the next game. And with 3 games in 7 days, obviously, you know, you got to be a little bit careful. But, you know, our guys are – they're doing a great job of taking care of their bodies and getting in to see Fred and all those guys. But, you know, we're excited about the 3 games in 7 days, but it also means a lot of different things because, you know, as soon as tomorrow night's over, boom, we got to get ready for Friday. So it's, you know, quicker turnarounds. Yeah, you know, and it goes back to the block shot thing. The reason we are blocking so many shots is because we're getting beat off the dribble so much. You know, it's most block shots and good shot blockers block their shots off the ball. And what I mean by that is it's not their man going to the rim. It's somebody else, and then they go and help. And the reason they're having to go and help is because we're getting beat. So, you know, there's drills we can do, but at the end of the day, it just comes down to just working on your individual defense. Get in a stance, take pride, and say, I don't want to let this guy beat me. Now, obviously, you're going to get beat. I mean, you're not going to prevent a team from getting in the paint. And so it's all about team defense, but it starts with individual. You know, guys just need to take pride in stopping their man one-on-one and not forcing too many rotations. But, you know, at the same time, our big guys understand that, you know, we have to protect the rim, and obviously they've done a very good job of that. But it's just a fine line because you got to be careful. You know, the more times someone gets beat and they go in there, here comes the big to block the shot. Well, now it could be a foul, so you just got to be careful about getting in foul trouble. But, you know, we've harped on it, not getting beat and the blow-bys. Just something we just got to continue to try to get better at.
Are the rotations fairly where you like to see them, or is that also something?
It's hit or miss. You know, a kid like Malik, for example, he's still trying to learn the rotation aspects. You know, sometimes in practice he'll go 2 or 3 trips and he'll be good, and then it'll be a different kind of rotation and he might struggle. But that's just part of the learning process. You know, it's just something you don't learn right away just because each situation is different. But they're getting it. You know, the good thing about our team is they love coming in with the assistant coaches, watching film, asking questions. You know, when anytime you get a group that asks questions, you know they want to learn. Instead of you having to initiate the conversation with them, they're coming in and saying, what can I do here? What should I do here? That's a good sign. So, you know, we're moving in the right direction. It's just, you know, like I've said, we want to be better tomorrow night than we were on Friday against Omaha. So that's our goal. No, I didn't think we took a couple challenge shots. I didn't think it was anything crazy. You know, we have guys in practice that don't miss, and then some for whatever reason we get in the game sometimes, and, you know, we just can't make a couple. But that's just part of the game. You know, the thing that has pleased me for the majority of the season so far, not all of it, is we haven't seemed to let our offense affect our defense too much. You know, and George Mason, I thought that was pretty evident. The other night we took all good shots. I think there were maybe 2 or 3 that weren't great, but you know, that's just something we just got to continue to strive for. Get the ball in the lane, drive and kick, and play inside to out. And, you know, as long as they're open, I told him, I said, look, you guys can go 0 for, you know, 25 in a row. As long as they're good shots, just keep shooting the ball and just have confidence.
In your mind, how does a team, if you've got a double-digit lead, how do you maintain that lead? What do you need to do?
You know, it could be a million different things. You know, it's a mindset with the players to not relax, which is, it's a lot easier said than done to do that. But, you know, it's there's just a million different things, you know. It's just part of the game flow. Sometimes, you know, we had a couple turnovers the other night that I was talking about, the you know, the live ball or the pick six turnovers, where all of a sudden they get two or three of those, and it's six easy points for them. And, you know, it's just little things. You got to take it one media timeout segment at a time. You just got to, you know, we're trying to tell our team all the time at timeouts, let's see if we can get three stops in a row. Let's just get three stops in a row, not worry about the offense, just try to get three stops in a row. And that's just the approach we have to have. But, you know, it's just a mindset of not getting complacent when you're up and just learning how to play as if the score is 0-0 at all times.
Dave, are you happy with your team's ability thus far to take advantage of the size difference they've had in games?
In certain areas, yeah. You know, giving up 22 offensive rebounds to that team the other night was not great. You know, that game the other night was funny. If you look at the stat sheet, I mean, you know, they shoot, I think it was 36% from the field for the game. They only made 7 free throws, and they scored 78 points. You know, you don't see that very often, but over a third of their points, I think, came from our turnovers. So we just, you know, we got to take care of the ball. But, yeah, you know, we got to do a better job of rebounding, team rebounding, defensive rebounding. You know, we're doing a decent job of offensive rebounding. Ray, Honest, Malik, those guys, even Dwayne, obviously, the other night rebounded well. But, you know, it's just, we just got to continue to improve, because we're going to face a lot of teams, and this team's actually one of them. You know, they have some size up front to where – we might not have a huge size advantage every night, so we can't just look at our opponent if they're smaller and just say, oh, well, we're gonna dominate inside because we're bigger. You know, it doesn't work that way. So we just got to look at every opponent the same and just treat it accordingly.
Anything else?
All right. Thanks, guys.